Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making oven roast turkey legs. And that may sound unusual to you because usually you hear of oven roast turkey or oven roast turkey breast, but we're just having the legs. And we like those occasionally. The meat is actually juicier and has more flavor to it than breast meat. But it's just a matter of preference, and you do have to know that there's going to be some skin and some fat on here. And also, when I make some gravy to go with this from the stock, I'll want to drain that really well because it will have a lot of fat. There's a lot more fat in the dark meat than you'll find in the white meat of the turkey. So it's just two drumsticks from a turkey. And they weigh 2 pounds total, so a pound each probably. And we're putting it in a roasting pan and covering it with a lid. By the way, I've already salted. I had this out here to remind me. I just used regular salt and I just sprinkled it on and worked it in a little bit with my hands. So it's ready to go. That's all I put on it. Now, if you want to put pepper on it at this point, that's fine, but it's not really necessary. I don't think it really enhances the flavor that much. So just cover it with a lid, put it in the oven at 350 degrees, and it will take maybe an hour and a half or 2 hours. Just keep watching it when it gets over an hour, and just occasionally check in on it, and you'll be able to tell when it's done, particularly if you have a meat thermometer. Just look for it to go up to where it says poultry, and that's about 180 degrees. So I'll see you back when we have this all roasted, and then we'll remove it from the bone and we'll have it served nicely on a platter, and I think you'll enjoy it. Here's what our roast turkey legs look like when they're done, and I will tell you they were in the oven at 350 degrees for 1 hour. And I checked them with a meat thermometer, and also just kind of looking at them and putting a fork to them, and they were done. So what I did was to turn the oven off and let them sit there a little bit in this pot while I was doing some other things to get dinner ready. So now I'm ready to deal with these. So I'm just going to take a meat fork and lift each one of these out and put it on a utility platter. And what I'm going to do is use that platter to work from, and then I will put some nice pieces of turkey on my serving platter, which will be this one over here. It only needs a small platter because we don't have a whole lot of meat here when you just have two fairly small turkey legs that you're working with. So I'll go off and make gravy from this. I'm not going to do an upload for gravy this time because I've already done fat-free turkey gravy. If you want to look that up, you'll see it's already uploaded from Thanksgiving. And there are other crock-pot turkey and many times that I've made turkey gravy. So that's just going to be for Rick and me. But you can look up a previous upload and you'll find that if you're interested. So I'm going to come back and show you the turkey legs. When they are taken off the bone and are ready to serve. Here is our finished roast turkey legs, and you'll see it's not a whole lot of meat, but for Rick and me it's more than one meal, definitely. And we usually don't eat meat that's that fatty, so we'll probably take the skin off and work at it that way. Here is my gravy that's almost fat-free. There might be a little bit of fat in it, but I always try to pour all of the fat off. So it's just made with cornstarch and water, and it's a very lovely gravy to have with the turkey legs. So let's go over to our serving plate, and what you'll find here is some rice that I've already uploaded if you're interested. This is herbed rice. It has three herbs from my garden in it, and then we have sauteed green beans with sliced almond topping. So you might like to use those to accompany your meal of roast turkey legs. So let's put a couple pieces over here. These are not large pieces because there are bones that come up the side of the turkey leg and makes it very difficult to actually slice into pieces. But Rick did a pretty good job on this. I'll have to give him credit. and then our gravy. I'm just going to put a little bit of gravy over the top of the meat. You could put this over your rice too if you wanted. As you can see, the consistency of the gravy, just look that up as low-fat turkey gravy in Betty's Kitchen if you're interested. And here is our whole meal. And with it, we're having soda, and I've topped it with a strawberry.